Good morning students. In our previous video we were discussing the MCQs of lesson number 3, that is metals and non-metals. So we are going to continue with the same. Now see the next question, which is, which of the following oxide of iron would be obtained on prolonged reaction of iron with steam? So when we see the reaction for this, iron plus water, we get iron oxide as Fe3O4 plus hydrogen. Balance it. So the correct option is C part, Fe3O4, iron oxide. Next is, which of the following are not ionic compounds? So out of these four, HCl is not an ionic compound, CCl4, carbon tetrachloride is also not an ionic compound. So the correct option is B part, second and third. These are not ionic compounds, rest KCl and NaCl, they are. 11th question is, the electronic configuration of three elements are given. Which two elements will combine to form an ionic compound, and write the correct formula? So out of these three elements, you can see the Y element has 7 electrons in its outermost shell and Z electron has 1 electron in its outermost shell. So to become stable, Y needs 1 electron to complete its octet and Z needs to lose 1 electron to become stable. So these two elements will combine to form ionic compounds. Now let us write the formula. Firstly, write the symbol. Then the valency. The valency of Y is 1 and Z is also 1. When we cross multiply, we get the compound as YZ. So, B is the correct answer. The highly reactive metals like sodium, potassium, magnesium, etc. are extracted by the electrolysis of their molten chloride. Which of the following non-metal is lustrous? So, out of these four, iodine is a non-metal, which is lustrous. Example of an amphoteric oxide is C part, aluminium oxide. Zinc oxide, aluminium oxide are both the examples of amphoteric oxides, and these are the oxides which show both acidic as well as basic character. Now question number 15. Which one among the following is an acidic oxide? So carbon dioxide is an acidic oxide. 16th question, the atomic number of an element X is 12. So the atomic number, so the element with atomic number 12 is magnesium. Which inert gas is nearest to X? So the inert gas which is nearest to X, that is magnesium, is argon with atomic number 18. Next question is, the process in which a carbonate ore is heated strongly in the absence of air to convert it into metal oxide is called calcination. So when carbonate ore is heated, the process is called calcination, and when a sulfide ore is heated, then the process is called roasting. 18th question is, oxides of moderately reactive metals like zinc, iron, nickel, etc. are reduced by using carbon as a reducing agent. So students, that's it for this video. In our next video, we are basically going to continue with more of the MCQs of this chapter, related to this chapter. So that's it. Thank you.